word.
Right.
And then he'll be okay.
Yeah, come he was
on.
Wrong.
That was wrong.
All right, y'all.
Go ahead.
Steve Ooh. Harvey was in the news a lot this weekend.
This was a big rumor this weekend, y'all. Y'all heard it?
First of all, he was in the it was several reasons why Steve Harvey was in the news.
Right, this one?
One was because, I don't know if you remember a while ago, we talked about Jess Hilarious. She was on The Breakfast Club, and she went in on Steve Harvey because apparently there was a tweet or Instagram, I don't know what it was, that somebody put on Steve Harvey's page that he did it, that said, name a comedian that's not funny or something like that. And Jess was like, why would he do that? That's right. Wrong. He's an OG.
Comedian himself.
And he's an older comedian. Older comedian, that's not really good because you could destroy somebody's that's just starting off.
Exactly.
Or a younger comedian. You not. That's like, I said, that's like a musician, Anita Baker or somebody saying, or Patti LaBelle. Posted, name some female singers who can't sing. She wouldn't do that.
Wow.
That's not, you're an OG in this thing.
Yes.
You're supposed to be mentoring them,
always,
not doing that.
Always.
So it went on that she went off on him for doing that and said she didn't like that he did that.
Okay.
When she brought it up on the Breakfast Club, Charlamagne and DJ Envy said, I don't think that's Steve Harvey. That don't sound like him.
Okay.
Remember I said when people say stuff, if people know you or watch you and they see who
that
you are.
That don't sound like the person I've been hearing.
And even if, let's say for the sake of argument, we become famous or whatever, and y'all start hearing stuff, y'all will be like, that don't sound like Kim and Lenore.
Right.
Like, I know what Kim, I know she do stuff edgy or whatever, but that don't sound like her.
Right.
Or that don't sound like Lenore. I think that's a lie. That's how he
That's
felt.
That's how Charlamagne felt with this comment.
Right. They felt it was a lie. And Steve Harvey felt like his fans should have known that he wouldn't have did that.
Wow.
So he was mad.
Okay.
So he came out and he said Steve Harvey apologized for that. It says that a post which was shared on his page last week asked followers to name a comedian they don't think find funny at all. Okay. Mm-hmm. So he came out and he said, somebody that works for me on my Twitter put a statement out that was totally negative. I got to take responsibility for it because they work for me. Ooh. But the engagement was talking about a name, a comedian you don't think is funny. Why would I do something like that? He asked.
Right.
That don't even make no damn sense.
I know
he said.
Yeah.
My whole brand is to be motivational.
Right.
And I'm going to turn around and say something like that.
What was this publicist thinking?
He said, you don't know where these young people are at in their career, man. That's what I said.
Right.
They could be coming up or anything. I'm all about positivity. I would never have done nothing like that.
Mm-hmm.
So Charlamagne and them was right. They said, I don't sound like him. It says, Steve said he was so pissed off and that he also confronted the employee who apparently told Steve that they were trying to increase his engagement on social media.
Oh my God, to even lie like that?
He said, okay, you trying to get some employment too, Steve continued. My bad, y'all. Now I gotta come on here and do this selfie. He calling his doing filming a selfie. That wasn't no selfie. That show you how old he is.
Oh wow.
So here it is. I'm sorry, man. My bad, y'all. It won't happen again. I bet you that means he fired that
man
person.
Is gone. That publicist is gone.
He said, oh, well, at least you know it's him this time. You can see Steve on the post. So this time it's him actually filming it.
Oh,
so that was the first thing. Yeah.
Yeah.
So Steve was all weekend. That was the first thing. So he had to come and apologize for that. The second one was them saying that his wife was cheating on him.
Having an affair.
Mm-hmm. Now,
I don't know who put that
if
out.
If you know anything about his wife. And we all
she does
know,
have a little shaky past. Her ex-husband.
We know her ex-husband is out, and he just got out of prison. Mm-hmm. He did time, and she was supposed to do time with him, allegedly.
Yeah, allegedly.
But he took the hit.
Yeah,
apparently that's what he's saying. Mm-hmm. He took the hit, and she didn't have to go.
And wrote a tell-all book about it.
And he wrote a tell-all book about it. And Marjorie is she gangster. According to him, she not this sweet innocent type of woman or whatever.
I felt she never was. Yeah,
no. But apparently, people were saying she was having an affair with her bodyguard or Steve's bodyguard.
Mm-hmm, right.
And that she was suing him, Steve, for $400 million and that she was filing for divorce.
I don't know where that
came Now,
from.
Steve eventually came out and said he was at some event and he was like, we good. Ain't nothing. That's not true or whatever. Mm-hmm. In other words, that's a lie.
Right.
I got to come out again and say something is a lie.
Oh, wow.
But I told my sister, he needs to be more worried to me. The fact that people believe it.
I know, because people.
That's the problem.
They took that lie and ran with it.
If somebody would have came out and said Denzel Washington's wife was having an affair with
this thing,
and she's suing him for $400 million, and she's going to leave him, people would be like, "That's not true."
Right.
Nobody said that's not true. Her,
how she carries herself.
Nobody said that this is not true.
Thank you.
Which leads me to believe people don't like his wife.
And they feel
sketchy about her.
Some people have been vocal about her. She's a little tough. But my thing is, I actually sat and watched a documentary of her and her ex.
Okay, what happened?
And I think even the one before him, because she had the one child by another man, I think.
Right. Laura. Her daughter.
She not the oldest, is she?
No. Her daughter, Laura, is not the man that's in prison.
Exactly.
Her dad is somebody else.
So Marjorie has a history as well as Steve.
Right.
And I read and I said, oh my God, was she involved with this one, that second one that's in prison? And what things was going on there? She's lived a high lifestyle profile always. Mm-hmm. So she got to continue to walk in that. But I said, and I went, ooh, I didn't know she was involved with somebody like that. And they was messy and he was messy. Allegedly, she was too. But they're saying kind of like the strawberry one. That's probably why he supports the strawberry lady.
The strawberry letter.
With her husband.
And her husband going through all this mess. Mm-hmm. And he's like, keep it out of the public.
Yeah.
That's between you and your man.
And keep moving
on. And everybody don't have nothing to do with that.
Right. I got your back. Keep doing the show.
Yeah.
Like nothing has hit you because things is going. Steve always talks about, even in his Christian walk, things do come at you. And you got to like be strong and believe God to go through it.
Mm-hmm.
Because they can be your enemies attacking you, throwing lies your way. And you just keep focused like the horse with the blinders on.
Wendy says that it was her husband's cousin, I think. It's Laura's dad or something.
So for Kim, which Kim is right.
Mm-hmm.
When a lie goes out and people, they click to it. Yeah, I believe that. Because she act like this, she act like this. They was quick to believe this.
So if I was him, I'd be more concerned that people was quick to believe that your wife did something.
Okay.
But he came out and said that that's all false.
Okay.
And that they good. Okay. And to be honest with you, who cares? I don't care about Steve Harvey and his wife.
No. I don't like him that way. I appreciate them and whatever they do to help, help in communities and whatever he does.
And Steve's hands ain't clean.
He gives back a lot too.
His hands ain't clean from previous marriages. So if it was true, so what?
His relationships with his kids.
You planted some seed and you're reaping it back.
We can't be surprised.
So let's hope that everything is good. Apparently, according to him, everything is good.
Okay.
So nobody, don't believe the hype is what he's saying.
Yeah.
All right. Let me skip over to
your next story.
Yeah, I don't have time to do that one. I want to show this.